Now friends, today the problem on hypocycloid. In our hypocycloid, our rolling circle rolls on inside the dieting circle. So here we have the dieting circle. And our rolling circle is inside the dieting circle. And in this problem, our radius of rolling circle, it is given 30 mm, and radius of dieting circle, it is given 90 mm. When we calculate the our theta, the path traveled by the rolling circle on dieting circle, this theta is equal to 360 into small r by capital R. So now we substitute the 360 into 30 by 90, that our answer, it is 120 degrees. So we take the 120 degree angle on dieting circle, where the our rolling circle, it is rolls in one revolution. So first we mark the our O1 center of the dieting. Then we take the 90 mm radius and draw the our dieting circle. Then we mark the initial position of our dieting circle. Draw the our rolling circle, which is rolls inside of dieting circle. So what I do, first I take the 30 mm radius, choose this point as a marking, and first we find out the our center. From this center, we create the our rolling circle. 30 mm radius. Then you can take the 120 degree angle. And you can show your final position after completion of one revolution by the rolling circle. Again you can create the at the end similarly method, you can create your the last position of your rolling circle. Now you divide your rolling circle with number of 8 parts. So first we draw the line exactly perpendicular to our line, then we join this opposite point at 45 degrees. Similarly, we are dividing this cordon in 45 degrees. Now friends, your rolling circle, it is moving anti-clockwise direction. If it is rolls anti-clockwise direction, so it can climb on dieting circle. So our starting points, as per problem statements, the point at contact between two circle. So first we mark our P0, that is our initial point. Similarly, you have the end point P8, where your rolling circle complete the one revolution. Again, your point P, it is touch to the dieting circle. Now for other point marking, my rolling circle, it is revolves anti-clockwise direction. I give the numbering in clockwise. So this is my first number, then it is the second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh, last eight. Now first we draw the all the circle and centers. So first we create our center line. This is our first center C0. So from O1 point center radius up to C0, I create the first our center of all circles. How to calculate your center of all the circle? You can divide your 120 degree angle, this 120 degree angle, in number of 8 division. So for that, we go for again same method of our previous problem. Each interval, it is a 15 degree. So I divide the entire 120 degree angle in number of 8 parts. Then we join with a center of directing lines. So it is cut the our main center of the rolling circle path. It is giving the all the different position of all the points. So there is a 4 division on right hand side. Similarly, you have the 4 division on your left hand side, where you can mark your center. This is my C1 center, then it is our C2, C3, C4, C5, C6, C7, and C8. Now the next step, that first we draw the all the circle pass from the rolling circle points. So first I draw the circle which is passed from 7 and 1. You can create the light circle. Then second circle you can draw from 2 and 6. Then next it is passed from 5 and 3. And the last it is our 4th. Now the next step, that we find out the different position of our loci of point P with choosing the different center. So now my ruling circle, it is moving anti-clockwise direction. So my thumb, it is point P. So when my circle, it is moving anti-clockwise direction, the point P, it is moving on this way. So you can get the half of moon on downward direction as a your hypocycloid. So how to get? So first you choose your C1 point center, rolling circle, it is radius, and draw the arc on first circle. The light 1-7 circle that I draw the arc on 1 and 7 circles. Then I choose the C2 point, it is a center. Then I draw the arc on 2 number circle. So the right circle, there is a P2. Then I draw the arc on 3rd number circle, so I got the P3. Then C4, it is a center. I draw the arc on 4th number circle. Then after the half revolution, your P point, it is a right hand side. So I change the direction of the arc and draw the arc on 5 number circle with C5 center. Then C6 center, I draw the arc on 6 number circle here. Then C7 center, I draw the arc on 7 number circle. So here you can get all the points. First we mark dark hits. Then we go for numbering of all the points. So your numbering, that is your P1, it is your P2, then it is your P3, this is your P4, it is your P5, this P6, P7 and P8. You can join with a smooth curves. You can start from your hypocycloid P0, P1, P2, P3, P4, P5, P6, P7 and P8. So it is our hypocycloid. Now draw the tangent normal on your given S point. Suppose I mark the S point, it is here. So what we do? First we find out the center of S point. So for that, I I join the O1 S and extend this line up to our center line. So it is cut my center axis as a CS. Sorry. First you draw the center CS. So I choose the S point center. I draw the arc on center line. It is giving our CS center. And you can join your CS with a O1 Now extend your line up to your dieting circle. Same method which we follow in our epicycloid. So it is cut to my dieting circle that I marked the S1 point. And I join S and S1 It is the normal now at the normal you draw the perpendicular line from the S point. You can decode here AB. It is your tangent to your given point S. Thank you, friends. Remember here, your rolling circle rolls inside the dieting circle. And the point P at contact between two circles, for one revolution of rolling circle, always we get our hypocycloid.